Okay, so my name is Rocio Cabrera, 22 years old, and I'm an artist from the Bronx.
Find your light, don't hide from what you are, and rise before you fall, and hope for something more. Live if you really want to.
In my art, there's a constant theme of like girl power.
This piece then says, ten cuidado, and for those who don't speak Spanish, it means be careful. And it's supposed to be like ovaries and fallopian tubes and the uterus, and I just want it to be badass, and I don't want people to think that they can fuck with girls.
I'm really into like honesty and being honest about your feelings and not being ashamed of them.
Okay, so this is my piece. These are my watercolor pieces because I don't paint usually, but when I do, they're usually just really emotional girls.
I'm usually inspired by boys, to be honest, as like embarrassing as that is to say. But every time I get screwed over by a boy, something beautiful comes from it. So I'm really grateful that there's a lot of idiots in the world. I had this one dude who was really protective and felt that he had ownership over my body and that I should be, I should cover myself up more in my art. So I have one piece where I'm like on my knees and I like listened to Yeezus the entire time making it, and I just felt really badass and I'm like tied up, and it just made me feel really tough, and it was a way for me to take control over my own body.
We could have been somebody. Thought you'd be different about it. Now I know you're not it. So let's get on with it. We could have been somebody. Said you had to tell somebody.
My favorite pieces are usually, as self-centered as it sounds, they're self-portraits of myself. They come from a place of vulnerability. I usually make pieces when I'm feeling the most self-conscious. But when I take these pictures of myself, which are usually nude, they're a way to step outside of myself and see that I'm like powerful and beautiful. I'm really into like confidence and just accepting your own sexuality and being proud of it, not being ashamed of yourself.
Being naked is like the truest form of yourself.
When I'm in the middle of painting or working on whatever I'm working on, I just feel really focused, and everything else is really quiet. Like when I'm able to focus my energy on one specific piece, like I don't have to worry about school or work or family. It's like nice to be able to focus yourself on one thing for a couple hours. Every time I finish a piece, like I feel like I'm gonna sound like a freak, but I feel like I'm like, it's like a baby. Like I have like a new thing. I have like a new piece of myself that I can have, and I get really attached to my pieces, and I don't like to sell them sometimes just because I get really devoted to them, and I'm really proud of them once I finish. I've sold like 5 pieces in my life, and I got really emotional about it.
So the first piece I sold was actually to a girl in Tampa, and I was so hyped and like so ready, and I ended up paying more money to send it out to her than she actually gave to me to buy, unfortunately, because I just didn't think it through, and I'm not used to selling pieces, and like shipping is a bitch, but it still felt really good, and I'm just really happy that I have artwork like hanging up in somebody's house, and next time I'm gonna do my math correctly and not make that same mistake, and it's gonna be great.
I've had a couple shows. I've been lucky enough to meet some really cool artists that are really open to like finding spaces for young people to show their work. I'm always really happy to sell pieces to whoever is interested in buying them.
Keeping all the people who were there to cheer me on. Cherish these moments before they're gone.
In a perfect world, I'd own my own art space. I'd be able to curate my own shows and make money that way, and also be able to sell my own art. A typical day in my life is me getting up at 7 in the morning and dragging myself to Hunter after the 6 train ruins my morning. Sitting through like 4-hour classes and then headed to the salon.
My job as a receptionist is really stressful because I'm not interested in hair at all, but I'm stuck in a salon 4 days out of the week trying to make some money, so it's a little depressing. I think I'm wasting my time, but it's a way for me to get some sort of income so I can live a life outside of school.
School has helped me because it's helping me learn how to work in other mediums, I guess. Like I'm not interested in ceramics or like collage necessarily. as an artist, I guess it's opening my mind to other things, but I don't know if my degree is really going to help me in the long run. I just think in order to accomplish what I want, I need to get off my ass and just stop being so complacent and like waiting for things to come to me, because it's not only about making art, but it's also about trying to get your art out there and like networking and not being so comfortable with just going to school and just going to work. We live in the best city in the world, and I know that's like so cheesy to say, but there really are so many opportunities. I just think it's really important that you are aware of your self-worth and that you take the gifts that you were blessed with and run with them and try your hardest to accomplish your goals, because you only have one life to live.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. No, there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.
I'd really like to be known for my art. I swear to God, I'd love if you looked at my art.